Hi students, welcome back to advanced English class. Today's chapter is asking for and giving directions. Directions are given to find an address. The sentences always begin with verbs. Landmarks are given as references to find an address easily. And also giving directions. If anybody comes to that place, if he is unable to identify or locate the address, generally the local people give address, directions. So how to give directions, how to get directions, both are there in this chapter. So on completion of this lesson, you will be able to ask for directions and give directions. So here is one activity, pre-activity. You have to go to the town hospital, but you are new to that town. How will you locate the hospital? Generally, we ask the person, local traffic constable, a local person regarding the address. We request them to show the address, to how to reach that directions. But nowadays we are using mobiles, maps, Google Maps to identify the location, how to reach it, instructions. Okay, that is not important. Here is activity one. Read the following conversation between a policeman and an old man. And guess what the conversation is about. Yes, first old man. Excuse me, do you know where the polytechnic is? Policeman. You mean government polytechnic at Masaptan? Old man. Yes. Policeman. Go straight till you reach the flyover. The flyover is not far away. Old man. Okay. Policeman. Take the left turn there. Walk a few yards and you will see a hotel. Golconda Hotel on your left. Old man. Okay. Policeman. Facing it on the opposite side of the road is Government Polytechnic Masaptan. Old man, thank you very much. Policeman, welcome. See here, you here. Old man asked for directions and the policeman gave the directions. So how the old man asked for directions? See, excuse me, do you know where the polytechnic is? Next, giving directions. Go straight till you reach the flyover. The flyover is not far away. Take the left turn there. Walk a few yards and you will see a hotel. Golconda Hotel on your left. Facing it on the opposite side of the road is Government Polytechnic Masaptan. Okay. Asking for direction and giving directions. Next, here one practice session, activity 2. Take turns to ask the questions given below. Okay, right. You have to practice this in examination point of view. In 1 mark questions and 3 mark questions, 5 mark questions, all types of questions will come from this lesson. So 1 mark questions, give 2 modal expressions how to ask for directions. Or in 3 mark questions, they give the situation, you have to ask for direction and also write giving directions also. Here are some modal expressions. How to ask for directions? How to get directions? Could anyone tell me where the bus stop is? So here very important is, when you use could anyone tell me, do you know, do you have any idea, tell me any idea, would you mind telling me, after these expressions you should not write sentence like question. So you have to write the helping verb at the end after subject, not before the subject. These are the subjects. These are subjects. Okay. So, could anyone tell me where the library is? Do you know where the post office is? Do you have any idea where the market is? Like that, you have to practice this activity. Okay, next activity 3. Here, some situations are there. You have to ask for directions. Ask for directions in the given situations. Right, how you ask for directions. So you have the expressions, modal expressions. Could you anyone tell me, do you know, do you have any idea, tell me any idea, would you mind telling me where, like that. You have to frame question here. You are in Hyderabad. You have to attend an interview at High Tech City. Ask a stranger where it is and how to get there. Here 2 points are there. Where is the High Tech City and how to go, get there? 2 points are there. You have to ask 2 points in the question. Okay. So the right answer, I will explain modal answer. Excuse me, could you tell me where is the High Tech City? Here mistake identified, no? Where is High Tech City? No. Where the High Tech City is. Could you tell me where the High Tech City is? Next, which bus goes to the High Tech City or how do I get there? Next, you have to visit a friend who is in hospital and ask how to reach the hospital. Your friend is in some Yashoda hospital. You have to ask how to reach the hospital, Yashoda hospital. In like phone conversation, you are asking the directly the person who is in the hospital, not stranger. You are not asking stranger. You are asking the same person who is in the hospital. So, hi, tell me how do I reach the hospital you are in? How do I reach the hospital you are in? Or in another way. Do you know how to reach the hospital you are in? Could you tell me how to reach the hospital you are in? There's number of modal expressions are there. Next, additional information. This is very important. First part you completed. How to ask for directions you completed now. Next, how to give directions and giving directions. For giving directions, you have to follow certain rules. That means you have to use some modal expressions or words. They are very important. You can use the following words when you are giving directions. Okay. Right. In one more question, they ask you give some at least 2 modal expressions while giving directions. Go straight on, అంటే స్ట్రైట్ గా వెళ్ళు, టర్న్ లెఫ్ట్ ఆర్ రైట్, వెన్ ఎడమ మళ్ళు లేదా కుడికి మళ్ళు, గో అలాంగ్ దీని అంటేనే వెళ్ళు, వాక్ అక్రాస్ దీని దీని మట్టి నడుచుకుంటూ వెళ్ళు, అవతల వైపుకు వెళ్ళు, వాక్ పాస్ట్ దాని పక్క నుంచి వెళ్ళు, యూ విల్ ఫైండ్ నీకు అనిపిస్తుంది. నెక్స్ట్ టు పక్కనే నీ దగ్గరలో ఆపోజిట్ ఎదురుగా ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ ముందు బిట్వీన్ మధ్యలో బిహైండ్ వెనక ఆన్ ఎట్ అరౌండ్ ద కార్నర్ ఆన్ అరౌండ్ ద ఆన్ ద కార్నర్ ఎట్ ద కార్నర్ అరౌండ్ ద కార్నర్ లైక్ దట్ ఆన్ ద లెఫ్ట్ ఆన్ ద రైట్ నో ఆన్ యువర్ లెఫ్ట్ ఆన్ యువర్ రైట్ లైక్ దట్ నెక్స్ట్ హియర్ ఈజ్ వన్ మ్యాప్ సో In this map, cinema, park, hotel, college, school, bookshops were marked. You are here. You are standing here. So, you have to give directions to cinema, you have to give directions to park, you have to give directions to school, bookshop, hotel, like that. So, first one, first model answer. Suppose if you want to reach the bookshop, here is the bookshop. If you want to reach the bookshop, you can give the directions like this. Go here, go straight, turn first right. Here are two crossroads are there. Here is one and two. So turn the first right. Turn the first right. Walk past the school. So cross the school also. You will see school. So, continue your walking. So, walk past the school for a few minutes. And you will find the bookshop on your left. You will find the bookshop on your left while you cross on this road. You will find the bookshop on your left. On your left. Next, school. Where is the school? Here. Go straight, turn first right, walk for a few minutes, okay, and you will find the school on your left. Next, cinema. Walk past, turn the second left. Go straight, turn your second left, walk past the park for few minutes and on your left you will find cinema. Suppose park, go straight, turn second left and walk for few minutes, on your left you will find park. In that same way you can write other addresses also. Other directions, other plan. So like hotel, college and etc. Suppose hotel, go straight, turn second right, you will find the hotel on your left, like that. Next, some common errors. What kind of mistake generally we make while giving directions or asking directions? So you will find it your left. No, you have to say you will find it on your left, not your left, on your left. Next, shall I turn to left or right? No, shall I turn? Here mentioned, shall I turn to left or right? No, don't use to. Shall I turn left or right? So, some tips. Begin sentences with verbs while giving directions. You have to use verb. Compulsory. Use landmarks. Landmarks are famous places like government buildings, school, college, temple, hospital, park, some other famous places. So they are called landmarks. Use landmarks as reference when you give directions. Next, assignments. Draw a sketch of your local area with as many landmarks as possible and write instructions directing your friend to reach your house. Suggest the means of transport also. So means of transport means how can you reach there, by bus or car or bike are the buses available or not? Are private vehicles means auto like that. Next assignment. You are in the classroom 2 in your college, and your friend who has come for the first time to your college is at the entrance. Give directions as he or she asks for directions. Go to different places mentioned in the box below based on the layout of the polytechnic. So you have to give address to, directions to principal's room, English lab, classroom 2, stores, office and playground. Here is the map. See the map. Playground. This is playground. This is called classrooms 1, 2, 3, stores, physics lab, chemistry lab, workshop 2, workshop 1, entrance, parking, auditorium, English lab, office, principal. So here your friend is here. You have to give address to classroom 2. You have to give address to, you have to give address to English lab. You have to give that means directions to principal's room. How do you give? I will explain one model answer. Go straight, turn left and walk past English lab and office for a few minutes, and you will find the principal's room on your left. For principal's room address, this is. Next, English lab address. Go straight, turn left, walk past the parking, you will find English lab on your left. In that way. Okay. 5 marks questions are, in 5 marks questions you have to write in a conversation manner. In that you have to write asking for directions, and also you have to give directions also in 5 marks and 3 marks questions. So this is the chapter. I hope you understood well, and listen once again and practice all the assignments. Write them in your file notes. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in our live class. Okay, with this I am ending the session. Thank you very much.